My name's Nick Maxwell, and I'm the head teacher at Cedar Hall School. Welcome to our assembly on Wednesday, the 17th of June. A little bit later than normal. That's because I've had some extra work to do, which you will be seeing later. So without further ado, let's go to the Golden Book. And we start off in red class with Scott. Scott has been busy there, as you can see, cutting up strawberries. They look delicious, Scott. And if you've got any mending that needs doing in your house, well, Scott's your man. There he is, busy mending a hole in his toy mouse. And good as new, I expect now, using the needle and thread. Well done, Scott. And here's Carlos. Now, learning to ride a bike without falling off is hard. And learning to ride on grass is actually even harder. Let's just see how well he gets on. Keep going, Carlos. Keep going. Keep going. Well done. Excellent. Fantastic. What an achievement. Well done, Carlos. Learning to ride confidently. In MP class, we've got Jason, who's been helping around the house and also helping with Granddad's shopping. Jack has been looking after, finding out about animals. And in fact, on that note, both Jason and Jack normally are part of my chicken crew. And, you know, the chickens send their greetings to you too. Look forward to the day when you can help me again at lunch times. And Phoebe has continued to have a good attitude at home. Well done, Phoebe. Here's Flynn making some lovely rangoli patterns. And I think that's rice that you've coloured yourself, isn't it? I don't know how you do that, but it looks amazing. Well done, Flynn. And not many of you would know, but Flynn is actually quite a rapper. Here he is with a homemade instrument. I think that's an idea taken from Mrs. Green's music on the website. So go and have a look if you want to see. Let's listen to his song here, his rap.
Miss you, primary. And yellow class, I miss you, yellow class, Mrs. Young, I miss MP, ML, MD, I miss Lachlan Mancock, I miss Mrs. Fruity Gig, I miss Mr. Brand, or I miss Mr. Maxwell, I miss everyone in primary, Cedar Hall School, Christmas, I miss Mr. Grinch, I miss Sporticus, I miss you, everyone.
Well, fantastic. We miss you too, Flynn. Well done. And there are other songs we haven't had time to play, like Queen, I think, amongst other tunes that you've learned to play. Well done, Flynn. Right. Moving on to MD class. Jake has been painting a bird feeder there, and he's also been picking strawberries, and I don't know whether it's, if you're anything like me, Jake, but when I used to go strawberry picking, it was one for me, one for the pot, but they look delicious, and that bird feeder looks fantastic. Very good, well done. Caden's been busy building a Lego ship there. Wow. Looks really detailed, and I'm glad you've put it on a shelf or on a cupboard there, because when you've spent all that time making something like that, you don't want to break it up, do you? You want to keep it and let play with it and let people admire it. So well done, Caden. Another person who's been busy is Alfie, and here he is. He's been dissecting flowers and then labeling them. So excellent, very, very good. And I think they're all right, having done a close-up look. I wonder if anyone can guess what kind of flower that is. It's a small one and it grows wild in the grass. Now, if we're in a real assembly, if we were at Cedar Hall, I'd be asking the question, put your hands up if you made your bed this morning. I wonder how many of you have made your bed today. It's an important skill, but Grace and Ilana have certainly been learning that. And they've not only just been able to make their bed from once you've slept in it, they can strip the bed and make it completely fresh. And they've been very helpful with washing and housework. So well done to you two. And Caitlin, she's been busy working hard with Lexia and some dogs. So well done, Caitlin, too. Now, I think I made a mistake a few weeks ago and said, Paris, your birthday was back in May. Do you remember? I had a picture of Paris up the tree. Well, actually, it was on Sunday. If it had been a day earlier, Paris, you would have shared a birthday with the Queen. We'd have to call you Queen Paris. But anyway, happy 14th birthday on the 14th of June. In GB class, now you probably don't recognise that because you can't really see his face, but that's Harry. He's grown so much, he's now being used to help redecorate their tea shop in Lee, Truly Scrumptious. I'm not sure it's open yet, but it's certainly getting ready for its reopening. Well done, Harry, for working hard and with your sister there too. So I'd recommend it. It's a lovely shop, a lovely tea shop. Congratulations to Billy again. Look how smart you look with your school uniform on having got your Jack Petchy Award. And as I said last week, the money that was that you won is going to go towards buying a bench, which we will enjoy back at Cedar Hall. And Grace, I wonder how many of you love reading. Well, Grace is certainly doing that. But if you look carefully down below, we've got Grace's cat here. Is that Smarty? And Elmo the guinea pig just there. And they enjoy listening to you read as well, I hear, Grace. So well done to you. Right, well, that takes us nicely on to saying goodbye, really, because our Year 11s left on last Friday, on the 12th. And so I'd like to mark this assembly by embarrassing you a little bit, some pictures of you guys when you were younger. So let's start off with Ethan. Now, Ethan loves music. He conducts a Salvation Army band in the High Street quite often. And here he is playing the tuba. And we'll miss you, Ethan. I'll miss those little chats on the playground. And I hear you've been busy walking your dog Stanley. And even building an obstacle course in your garden, which you have a go at. So we wish you all the best as you go to Lancaster. And just between you and me, Ethan, I'd like a jar of strawberry jam from your farm shop next time you're there. It's a private joke. He'll understand. Moving on, there's Harry. Harry, when you were in middle school, you've always been interested in learning about things and why things happen. And this was the time when that science guy came along, and it looks like there's going to be an explosion at any point from the PPE you're wearing there. And so wish you all the best, Harry, as you go on to Lancaster. And here's Pirate Ryan. Yeah. Ryan's been to Fellowship Afloat many times, And yes, he certainly knows how to arr. And there he is steering his ship to safety. And I hear that, Ryan, you've been busy making a water fountain and knocking down a shed. So well done for that. And we wish you all the best as you move on to Lancaster next year. Now, I couldn't resist that picture, Ryan. What a sweet little face. Not that you're not, that you still don't look handsome, chappy. In fact, I hear you've just had a haircut, actually. Always happy, Ryan, always happy. And that's a lovely, lovely thing to be. So well done. We're going to miss you. And I hear that you're off to Lancaster too with your friends. You've been enjoying being at home, I hear, in the last few weeks. And here's Bobby. Bobby, you're going to miss your morning. Say good morning to Bobby every day at the gate. And I believe that, Bobby, you're off to Castledon, aren't you? And you're probably looking forward to joining Jamie there. And this was when you were in middle school. And what a lovely model you made there. So all the best to you, Bobby. And Clarissa. Well, Clarissa is always kind. Always kind and thoughtful. And I hear, Clarissa, that you've even adopted a cat. And you've been looking after a cat in your neighbourhood during lockdown. Wish you all the best as you move on to Lancaster as well. Well, James looks like a managing director of a company there, doesn't he? And James, I think everyone would agree with me that you're a very kind, helpful and thoughtful person. Must take after your mum and dad, of course. And we wish you all the best as you move on to St Christopher's, I believe. So do pop back. And that goes for everybody. Now, everybody probably in the school knows how good Ollie is with electronics. There's a problem on the computer, he'd normally be the person to ask. And he'll be able to help you out. I didn't know you were a good cook as well. So probably a few years ago. Anyway, we wish you all the best as you go on to Southend College. And I'm sure you'll do very well there. And Aidan, well, going to miss your chats on the playground, Aidan, as we watch the football. Always willing to have a chat with me. And this was a good time we had at Fellowship Afloat, wasn't it, Aidan? Lots of good weather and fun times. So happy memories. Wish you all the best as I think you're going to CIVIC, aren't you? And I think you've been doing some work already for that. So well done you. Do pop by and see us at lunch times when you can. Well, look at that face, Reese. Innocent face there. Another Fellowship Afloater. And I hear that, Reese, you've been busy with Scare Electrics and train, is it model railway train? And even painting, redesigning the logos on one of your cars. So, and cooking and fishing. So you've been keeping busy over lockdown. Well done. Wish you all the best as you move on. And here we've got a picture of Corley and Jamie, partners in crime. Yeah, butter wouldn't melt in their mouths, would it? Well, well done to both of you. Corley especially has turned it around in the last few months at school and really knuckled down. And I'm sure you'll do well as you move on to Southend College. And Jamie, I hear you've been busy during lockdown in the garden and in helping in the house. Wish you all the best as you move on to CIVIC. And remembering that I think that's the Duke of Edinburgh expedition that you had to do, and it was a really hot time, wasn't it? But happy memories, eh? So moving on to 11S now. Wow, look at that. Billy, I couldn't resist that angel face picture. So Billy, we've already said how you've done well. In fact, you know, a few years ago, if Billy came into my office, it was because he was in trouble. But these days, the last few months, he's been popping in just for a chat, which is great. Wish you all the best as you go to CVIC, Billy. And here's Connor. Not me, Gov, it wasn't me. Looks like that's what you're saying there. I hear that you're off to a brand new college or new building of Basildon College in September. Wish you all the best with that, and well done for finishing off your V-cert work, which you've done for Mrs. Hoy. Wish you all the best in the future. Right, well, here's Jackson at Fellowship Afloat. It took me many years to get you to Fellowship Afloat. Do you remember, Jackson? You weren't too sure about going, but when you did, you had a great time. And you know what I'd say about you, Jackson, is you're a great friend. Lots of people value your friendship, and I know you've been busy over lockdown, walking with your family and studying as well. Wish you all the best as you go to CVIC. And moving on, two more partners in crime, Sarah and Grace. Sarah, you're moving on to CVIC, I believe, and I know you've been busy cooking and working on your computer during lockdown. Well done to you. And Grace, we've already seen that you've been busy reading. Loving the hat there, Amazing Grace. I tease her and call her Amazing Grace. So well done to you too. It's been lovely knowing you too as well. Well, we're getting to the end, and here we have Ben. Ben, I hear that he's been playing table tennis, riding your bike, helping around the house, keeping busy, and you two are off to Castledon, I think, with Grace. So I'm sure you'll do well there, Ben, and we wish you all the best as you move on. And last now, but not least, Alicia. Now, that picture, Alicia, is of you in middle school, and I think it's in the middle school performance, and it looks like you're baton twirling there, and I know that you're still part of the baton twirling, because we've mentioned that in an assembly, haven't we? So wish you all the best with your work and going on to CVIC. I hear you've opened a bank account already. Checks payable to Mr. Maxwell, holiday fund would always be welcome. So wish you all the best, Alicia, as you go. So that's all our year 11s moving on. And I did enjoy watching that that video that Mr. Sankey and Mr. Brandle and Mrs. Cornell made. Of saying the best days of your life. Well, I'm sure you've got the best days ahead of you too. So finally, the last slide of the Golden Book is our helpfulness trophy, Charles Colwick helpfulness trophy. It goes to two people. Jamie was nominated because he was going for a walk along a river. I think it was a river, or was it a canal? It must have been a canal because it's a lock near Chelmsford. And he saw that a puppy or a couple of puppies had fallen in the water or jumped in the water, and the owner couldn't get them out, and they were in danger. And and Jamie, being the big-hearted man that he is, reached down and managed to save the puppy. So well done, Jamie, for doing that. And Mrs. Hannon. We all love Mrs. Hannon, and she's been working really hard to look after staff, phoning them, writing to them, and caring about their well-being. So you are both worthy winners of the Charles Colwick Helpfulness Trophy. So thank you for you two. And we'll finish our assembly with a short prayer. We normally do that in at Cedar Hall. And I'd like to just have a short prayer for our Year 11s as they move on. If you don't want to pray, that's fine. But those who do join me. So Heavenly Father, we thank you for the Year 11s. We thank you for the fun and the learning that they've had in the time that they've been at school. And we pray for them as they move on to the next step of their lives. We pray, Lord, that they wouldn't be anxious, that they would have peace, and that they would really enjoy this next step, and that you would keep them safe, and that they would be able to come back and visit us in the future. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen. So thank you for watching and listening, and just a reminder that I've had some pets being shown, and you'll see that there's a video of staff pets. Look, you don't want to be outdone by the staff, do you? I haven't had that many pet pictures come in. So if you've got pictures or short videos, less than a minute, we'll include them in next week's assembly. So thank you. Take care and look after yourselves.